We're in Trainiacs. So, earlier this week, we did a podcast with Dan Plews, the 2018 Kona amateur champion who set an all-time Kona course record as an amateur. Nailed it. So the interesting thing about Dan Plews is that he is, in addition to being an awesome athlete, he is also a sports scientist. And one of the things that he has been publishing a bunch of papers on is heart rate variability training. And this is potentially a like four times improvement, better way of training than just saying, all right, well, I'm gonna go really intense Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, have an easier day Monday, Friday, and then go longer but less intense Saturday, Sunday. Like, we're talking a four times improvement over that. But the issue with it has always been, how do you actually implement it practically? Because we can't all just wake up every morning and say, oh, well, my heart rate variability is good today, so what am I gonna do? We have to have some sort of structure. Dan Plews helped with that, and that's what we're gonna talk about today. Hold on to your butts, Trainiacs, because it's about to get all science-y up in here. Don't worry, I'm a Canadian, so I will dumb it down by necessity because I don't know words that have more than three syllables. So HRV training, heart rate variability training, is the concept of, instead of just laying out a typical week and saying, well, on these few days, I do these workouts, on these days, I do these workouts, on these days, I do rest workouts. HRV training is using heart rate variability, which is the variation of the time between your heartbeats. So even though your heartbeat might be beating, let's just say 60 beats a minute, that is actually irregular. One beat might be 1.05 seconds apart from the previous one, then 0.97 apart from the previous one, then 1.07 apart from the previous one. And what you want is a lot of heart rate variability. You want your heart to beat irregularly. That means it's a good indication that your body is ready for upcoming workloads. If it's just beating regularly, just going thump 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 thump, instead of thump 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 thump, that's kind of exaggerated. But beating irregularly is beating when it needs to. Thump 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 is just going through the motions. That's what happens when it's under a lot of stress on, say, the treadmill, on a stationary bike. When you're pushing really hard, it gets really regular because it can't choose when to beat. So it just says, you know what, I'm just gonna beat regularly, boom, 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 boom. But we don't wanna live in that state of stress. So a high heart rate variability when we're resting is what we want. If instead of just using that typical week, we say, all right, well, on days where our heart rate variability is high and we're very ready to work out, we end up performing more, we do our key workouts, but on days where our heart rate variability is very low, we back off. So we wait until we need a rest to take that rest. And here is what this has resulted in several studies, but this is the one that Dan Plews shared with us. Training prescription guided by heart rate variability in cycling. So what they did in this study, and I will link to it in the description below for anyone who really wants to dive into this, and I'm sure I'm gonna say things incorrectly, but this is the gist of it. What they did was they did a baseline test to see what two groups' heart rate variability, just standard, tends to be. Then what they did was they split the groups and they said, all right, this group over here is going to do traditional periodized training where their week is laid out to them. This group over here is going to use heart rate variability training. And what they did, instead of just saying, all right, if your heart rate is low this day, you are going to rest. If it's high the next day, you are going to go hard. They took a rolling average of 7 days in a row. And if the 7 day rolling average, like the average of your previous 7 days, ended up dipping below 1/2 a standard deviation of your baseline, then you're prescribed a rest day. If it was still below after that, you're prescribed a second rest day to a maximum of 2 rest days in a row. And here are the results. Here is why this is so interesting. The heart rate variability group improved their peak performance output, this is their maximum power potential, by 5.1% on average. Then, from an endurance standpoint, they improved their 40K time trial results by 7.3% on average over the course of an 8-week trial. Here is the thing. The traditional training group did not improve significantly after the 8-week trial. And I have seen, probably this is, I want to say, the third study that has shown similar sorts of results by using heart rate variability instead of just a standard week. Gets you thinking, right? Okay, so how do we actually do this in practice? Let me show you. So I have made a spreadsheet that you can go and download at triathlonterran.com/, let's go HRV training. And that's where we start taking the science and you can actually apply it to your training. So what you need to do to start out is get some sort of a device that captures HRV. Right now, I'm using the Oura Ring, which does it as I sleep, but you can also use just your phone. If you use an app called HRV for training, this is probably the simplest way to get a recording for your HRV. What you do is you place your finger over top of the camera, probably easier with that finger, over top of the camera, and at the same time every morning, immediately after waking up and going to the bathroom, you measure HRV, and then it uses the, there we go, uses the light and the camera on your phone to get an HRV measurement. So whether you're doing it with an Oura Ring, whether you're doing it with a chest strap, whether you are doing it with HRV for training, there are very simple ways to get an HRV measurement. What you then do is you take all of those daily measurements and you put it into this document that you're going to get at triathlonterran.com/HRV training. And you're going to have to create a baseline. So for 30 days, start entering the readings. And the readings are going to vary. With the Oura Ring, it goes from 20 to 100. On this, it goes from like 5 to 9. It really doesn't matter because it's going to be measuring the same thing, but there is no standard HRV measurement. So that's why the numbers are going to be different. But as long as you are using the same measurement tool all the time, that's what's important. So you start putting in all of your data. And how this spreadsheet works is after 30 days, it's going to calculate, well, after 7 days, it's going to calculate your 7 day rolling average. After 30 days, it's going to calculate a baseline for you. And if you're really interested in what that is exactly the same baseline as what they used in that study. And it is the average of the previous 30 days, and then the baseline bottom, like where we start actually changing our training, is 1/2 of a standard deviation. So I've built in a standard deviation calculation, and then the baseline calculation is the average minus 1/2 of the standard deviation. And then what's going to happen is, as you just continue to put in measurements over and over, it's going to be calculating constantly your 7 day rolling average. And let's say I start dipping down here for a while. If I really dip down there, boom. If I start dipping down, it's going to eventually give me a reading that is red on a day. And if you have a day that's red, then you back off your training because that is less than your baseline. And don't worry if, like happened here, I just put in one low number and all of a sudden something went red down there. That doesn't matter. What you're looking at is how your 7-day rolling average is every single day. And as long as that 7-day rolling average doesn't turn red, you go after it and either do a moderate intensity long workout or a short workout with a lot of intensity. But as soon as you get a red reading saying that your 7-day rolling average is less than your baseline, you have to take one day off. And if that isn't enough, you take another day off. Days off can be an entire day off or a recovery swim, a recovery bike, a really low intensity, like zone one kind of heart rate sort of day. What I've also built in here that they've said is important in this study is that every month or so, it recalculates a new baseline for you. So right now, my baseline is actually quite low because I had the back injury, because I was traveling with Kona, my training wasn't going well. So I have a very low baseline at the moment. I imagine after 30 days, it's going to reset itself and it's going to be higher. So in that case, HRV is always measuring basically what my current baseline is, what my current level of preparation is, and which days I actually need to take rest. Hopefully, I get like 7% faster. Now, is that critical for you to incorporate into your training plan? No, absolutely not. Most pros don't even do that. But there is so much being said over the last 3 years about heart rate variability, with most of the companies talking about it, Oura Ring, HRV for training, aren't really necessarily talking about it from the standpoint of, all right, practically speaking, how does somebody implement this? And if you are thinking about testing out heart rate variability and you've got the flexibility to change your training day by day, this spreadsheet is a way that you can do that. And it actually gives you concrete walls and like structure for how to do that. So if you do want to play around with it, it's very inexpensive to do. Just grab a phone, HRV for training app, any sort of heart rate strap that does do HRV, heart rate variability, and go to triathlonterran.com/HRV training, get this spreadsheet and start tracking it. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna start testing it out, and geez, you are worked up. Exciting. Science. All right, Trainiacs, go to triathlonterran.com/HRV training if you want to start playing around with this and have some fun. Let me know how it turns out for it. Later.